Did you ever wonder how to track the movement of your character in your animations? The answer is the motion path. As you can see, the motion path tracks the movement of each joint or controller of your character throughout the timeline. If you have an object that don't have any rig or armature and move throughout the timeline, you can track the motion path in the object properties, motion path, and you can select a range and click on the calculate. As you can see, the motion path of this cube is shown to us. But if your character has armature, if you go to the object motion path and calculate it, as you can see, all the dots on all keyframes are spawned on the 3D cursor. The reason is our object is not moving at all. It's the armature that's moving. In order to calculate the motion path for your armature, go to the pose mode first, select the bone that you need to track, go to the object data properties, and calculate the motion path of this bone. As you can see, the motion path is already calculated. You can keep the motion path of this bone and add another bone to your calculations, like this. So you can track both bones at the same time. You can clear the motion path by clicking the clear button here, or clear all by clicking the second one. Also, if you change anything throughout your animation, for example, if I move something here, in order to update my motion path, just click update path or update all path. The motion path has a few settings that I explained to you right now. The path type is in range. It means it will calculate the curves in the range that you give in or in the range of the entire scene. You can change the range from here, alt keys, selected keys, scene frame range, and manual range. As you can see, you can change which range to show you the motion path. For example, 50 to 100. As you can see, only the range of 50 to 100 is shown to me. Also, you can select round frame. As you can see, it shows 10 frames before and after the current frame of your animation. You can change this range from here, frame range before and after. In the display tab of the motion path, you have a few settings that's worth mentioning. As you can see, you can turn on and off the frame numbers, keyframes, lines, and thickness of the line that I can increase in order to have a thicker line. The keyframes shows the number on the keyframes, and the frame number shown the number of the frames. The difference from the keyframes and frame numbers is frame numbers shows all the frames of your animations from 1 to the end of your animation. But the keyframe only shows you the keyframes numbers. For example, this is a motion capture, so every frame has a keyframe. But in your animation, if you set 2 or 3 or 4 or more keyframes, it only shows you the keyframes, nothing more. Let's clear this. You can add the calculate of the motion path to your quick favorite menu by right-clicking on it and add to quick favorites. Now in the scene when I press the Q button, I have the calculate. I press that and I have the options. You can also add the clear button to your quick favorite so you can clear your bone motion path. If you want to know how to add the motion capture like this to your character or even retarget your current motion capture to your character, I put the link on the top right corner. There are two ways, the free version with the Rococo add-on and the paid version with the AutoRig Pro add-on. And also for rigging your character, I have two videos, one with the Rigify that is completely free and one with the AutoRig Pro that you need to buy the add-on before rigging your character. That's it for this video. If you like the video, please hit the like and subscribe to the channel. More videos like this on characters, texturing, rigging, animations going to upload soon. So stay tuned, have a great day, and bye bye.